Giovanni Francesco Bernardone. Frankie was the stereotypical Italian playboy. He came from a wealthy family, so he had all the money he needed to spend his days the way he spent his nights, partying, drinking, and carousing. Then war broke out. Not exactly the military type to begin with, it didn't take long before Frankie was captured. He would have been killed, but his captors thought he might be worth ransoming back to his father. Easier said than done. He rotted in an Italian prison cell for almost a year before payment was finally worked out and he was released. It came as no surprise that he came home sick, not just physically, but with symptoms of what sounded a lot like PTSD. It took him another whole year to recuperate. During that time, his health improved, but so did his attitude. Now in his early 20s, Frankie began to look for something more in life, a sense of meaning and purpose. He found both in the life of Jesus. The change was dramatic. It was as though he had been struck by lightning. He started spending more and more time praying and seeking God. He told of having dreams and visions. In fact, one time while he was praying, he felt the Lord tell him to repair his church. He figured that meant fixing up the church he was praying in, so he started selling off family possessions to raise money for the job. When his dad found out, he said, I don't think so. He actually took his own son to court and demanded to be paid back. Okay, fine. Frankie not only paid him the money, but took the clothes off his back and laid them in a pile in front of his dad and walked out. But it turned out the church that needed repairing wasn't just the building he was sitting in that day. God had something bigger in store for Frankie, who is actually better known by the name of Francis, Francis of Assisi. Leaving all of his wealth and security behind, Francis began a humble ministry built entirely around what Jesus told his disciples when he sent them out to preach. As you go, proclaim this message. The kingdom of heaven is near. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse those who have leprosy, drive out demons. Freely you have received, freely give. Don't get any gold or silver or copper to take with you in your belts. No bag for the journey or extra shirt or sandals or a staff, for the worker is worth his keep. The idea of living a lifestyle of poverty was a pretty radical notion at the time. The church of that day was incredibly rich, as were the people in charge of it. So Francis made it his mission to confront the materialism and decadence he saw around him and restore Jesus' original values. His message touched a nerve. Thousands came to hear him preach, and many others wanted to follow his example. It wasn't long before the group became known as Franciscans, and they left a greater mark for good on medieval Europe than most of the heroes who made history at the time. Francis was known as a gentle man who loved nature and animals, peace and serenity. Not the kind of type A leader we typically think about, but the secret of his success might just come from what many people said about him, that he lived out the Sermon on the Mount better than anyone except the first man who preached it. That's called leading by example. See you on Sunday.